So this is a couple days old, and I know a lot of people have already covered it, but I wanted to cover it just to put it in my little repertoire of what I'm talking about as far as like big people getting into Bitcoin. This is billionaire with a B, hedge fund investor Drunken Miller. That's a good name. Says he owns Bitcoin and CNBC interview. And pretty much what he says, and he pretty much shocked everybody because this guy apparently is like a legend in the traditional investing world, just like PTJ, just like Paul Tudor Jones. When you have these types of people been around for quite a bit of time, have quite a bit of knowledge, and they have the public ear and they're saying, hey, Bitcoin's not bad, I invest into it. It shifts the perception. Not that it's really he's going to move it. I mean, just his little bit amounts of Bitcoin. If he does, he may have a lot. I don't know. But just by him mentioning it and saying it changes the public perception. I think this is a good thing for Bitcoin. And it's quotes. First of all, it quotes that Drunken Miller, who just weeks ago said he's going to be shorting the dollar, is going long on Bitcoin. That says something right there. Though he said his gold position is many, many more times larger than his Bitcoin allocation, Drunken Miller predicts his Bitcoin would outperform. And that's the thing about investing. We're always looking for an asymmetrical investment. So yes, gold will probably go up at some point. Sure. But is it going to go up 10x, 20x, 100x? No, it's not. There's no way, because it's already at sitting around $12 trillion. So it's not going to go from $12 trillion to $120 trillion. It doesn't work like that. But Bitcoin is only around $300 billion or $280 billion. Could it go up 10x, 100x? Sure. Why not? Well, maybe not 100x. Let's just keep it at 10x and just, you know, about, you know, 140,000. That could totally happen. He also states that, frankly, if the gold bet works, the Bitcoin bet will probably work because it's thinner, more illiquid, and has a lot more beta to it. Basically, it's just better. I can transfer Bitcoin to anyone, anywhere in the world for next to nothing. And it's the best performing asset class of all time. It's beaten gold, oil, stocks, everything. Used to cost a nickel. Now it's costing around almost 16,000. That's why I heavily invest into it. Bitcoin elevator pitch. Very simple today. Anyhow, it has a lot of attraction as to store of value to both millennials and the new West Coast money. And they got a lot of it. Drunken Miller also says he's anticipating a 3 to 4 year decline in the dollar. So, look, I'm not going to get into the whole dollar thing. We've talked about that before. But I just wanted to have one more guy in the little army of people that I tend to talk about when I start to talk about why Bitcoin's going to make it. And I always talk about the same type of thing. Because if you're new, you don't know this. If you're old, you get kind of bored of me saying the same thing. But I have to say the same thing. It's because there's new people and people got to hear it like 8 or 10 times. But it's just like Fidelity Digital Assets with 8 trillion assets under management. I mean, they're in the game for digital currencies or digital assets and cryptocurrency. You got TD Ameritrade, 1 trillion assets under management. You got VanEck and they're huge gold bugs. And they put this out in January and said, look, Bitcoin is way better than gold. And here's 7 reasons why. On top of that, you got Grayscale gobbling up everything as far as crypto, well, as far as Bitcoin, Ethereum per se, because there's so much demand for it as far as institutional investors. You got this guy, Paul Tudor Jones, who came out and said, hey, I'm a legend and I'm going to invest a ton of money into Bitcoin. Well, not a ton, but he's going to put 2% of his total investments into Bitcoin futures. Who knows what he's doing behind the scenes? That's just what he said publicly. On top of all these great public companies like MicroStrategy, Galaxy Digital, Square, and all these companies that put a ton of money into it. And look how massively they are up in a very short amount of time. You're looking at MicroStrategy, they just got this 2.5 months ago, and they're almost 200 million. Do you think they're not looked at as visionaries? Galaxy Digital, they have 134. Hey, look, they're almost doubled. Square, 50, 75, not too bad. Not too bad for about a month or so. And then the report just goes on and on and on. So these are the things I like to talk about because these are what will lead you to go, look, I think I'm in the right place at the right time doing the right thing. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Let's move on to our last piece, Q of the day.